Oh my goodness, it's time to open up my Lightroom and send those contact sheets to Hunter. Hey guys, my name is Priscilla Elias, and before I explain exactly how you can easily create proof or contact sheets in Lightroom, please, if this video helps you, I kindly ask you that you click the like button, subscribe to my channel, and click the little bell down here so you'll be notified when I release new videos. This way you'll help me to be able to keep creating more and more content for you. Being able to send nicely organized contact sheets is crucial in photography. As soon as I started working as a professional photographer, one of my first doubts overall was, how am I going to send my clients all of their photos so they can choose the ones they want in an easy and organized way? I soon realized that that was one more thing I could do in Lightroom, and now I'm gonna teach you how to create contact sheets in Lightroom. I took the session I did for Hunter because he signed his model release and he told me he wouldn't mind to be in the video. What? How he told me? He said, Yeah, those were his words. You don't believe me? I'll bring him up here. Hunter, tell him what you told me. Huh? Didn't you let me use your photos? Okay, so here we go. First thing, open up your Lightroom Classic, go to your library and choose all the files you want to be sent from the session. At this point, I usually already did a pre-selection of the images and I already rated the ones I'll send the client. Before I send the images to the client, I create a collection in Lightroom with all of the photos from the session. I delete the blurry ones or the ones the client has their eyes closed, and I rate the ones I want to send the client with 5 stars. And you can also rate them with 1, 2, 3, 4 stars, or even you can put colors on them. You can just click 7, 8, 9 on the keyboard to choose different colors. So you can rate them with stars or with colors or both. If some of the photos are too dark or too bright, at this time I already do some light correction also. After all, the more photos the client likes, the more photos they want to keep and the more extra photos I'll sell. Okay, so you select all files. And once you have them all selected, you go up here to print. And if you don't see it, click on this arrow up here in the middle. The menu might be hidden. You can already see your photos here at this point, and here's where you can set the contact sheet in a way you think is best. You can do a bunch of stuff here, so you can zoom to fill, you can rotate to fit, you can just mess with it a little and see what looks best for you. So as you see, I always keep my watermark over the photos for the contact sheets in order to protect the images until they've been chosen. This is something very simple to do as well. If you have a logo, you just upload your file over here, and once the file is uploaded, you can just set the transparency, the size, and everything else. If you don't have your logo, you can just write your name or the name of your company right here, like this, and that will work as well. Now let's go to the final step. Now you have all your images selected, you go to printer, and here you'll see this PDF mark, save as PDF. I'm saving it to desktop. Put the name on your file, here, title, Hunter, save, prepare and print job, and boom, that's it. Here it is on my desktop. Now I just get this file, throw it in Google Drive, and you can also use Dropbox or OneDrive or any other tool you use for storage and sharing, and you can share it with your client. They'll later get back to me with the number of the photos they want, and I'll edit only the ones they choose. So, did you think this was going to be easy? Crazy easy. Easy cheesy. As we'd say in Brazil, fichinha, moleza. I want to see you practice that. So thanks for watching this, guys. Before you go, if there's anything you'd like me to talk about, just let me know in the comments below. I would love to help you out. I'll see you in the next video. Ciao!